Friends, in previous video, we have seen the introduction portion of TempCAD. In this video, we are going to simulate two basic unit operation, namely mixture and splitter, and how to simulate them using TempCAD. Right? So, in previous video, we have already seen that we created a system of water and methanol. So these are the two components we have taken. Our thermodynamic also was set, that is PRK. So we will go ahead with that. And we are supposed to simulate a mixture. So the first thing you have to do is take a feed stream from here, drag and drop. Another feed stream, drag and drop here. Take a mixture. So find out the mixture here. From the given unit operations, put it here. And take a So the basic thing in CAMCAD is that you have to specify feed and product as far as input and outputs are concerned. However, for any intermediate input and output system, you don't need to select feed and product. And as we proceed further, I think we'll be able to see this. Again, connect this pink dot to blue dot, this pink dot to blue dot, and this pink to this one. Now specify the streams. So since no mention of temperature pressure flow is given in this, we will specify according to our own understanding. So we go with mole fraction here. Let's say we say only water is present here, with this flow rate to be kilomole per hour, and I say 100 kilomole per hour. The temperature, let's say 200. Pressure, let's say 14.7, and I flash it. I give the name here. I can give the name as well. So this is water, right? Okay. So this is one stream. You can see that it is chained to water. Now this is, let's say, methanol. So let's say methanol, right? Temperature we say 150. Pressure 14.7. And we can give the mole fractions. Here it is 0 and 1, it is pure methanol. And I say that flow rate here in kilomole per hour is 250. Fine. And then I flash it. Fine. So I have a liquid methanol and liquid water getting into the mixture, and it should get this. Now see, in CAMCAD you don't get the outlet directly, like, you know, to get this values you have to run the system. So what you need to do is you need to select and then click on run selected. Once you click on this, this message box will show you the details. Started input data check. So the input data was found proper. Then there were no errors in that, and then run started and run finished, and what is your output? This is your output. So this you can say mixture. So mixture is having temperature 160, then pressure 14.7, liquid only, enthalpy, total flow. Now total flow, if I want it into this, I can convert into mole fraction. So you can see naturally, since the methanol flow was more, the mole fraction of methanol is more. And if you want to change this to kilomole per hour, this becomes kilomole, because 100 and 250 will be different. Right? So this is something which we can get when we mix two streams. Now we also want to, you know, simulate a splitter, that is a flow splitter. Now when we mix, the composition changes. When we take a flow splitter, it is only the splitting of the flow. So if I look at flow splitter, from the pellet, at times it becomes difficult to identify what we are searching for. Mixture is there. Okay, yeah, so this is the divider or the splitter, and what happens in splitter is that I need to add a free product, add a stream, and it goes to the splitting. So I'll just remove this, and put this here. Just connect this blue dot. This doesn't require a product stream as I have shown you earlier. So now the splitter will require two product, it's going to be end. So minimum two is required. So I connect to this, and then I'll first run this so that I get the run selected. So I got this stream, which is a mixture. Now I'll name it as a mixture. Okay, right, and then I need to run this. Now when I want to run this, I am splitting the flow, so I should identify what amount of flow is getting splitted. So I'll again make this mole fraction, and this will run like this. Okay, and I click on this. So whatever unit operation you are having, and if you want to simulate that, and you need to add some parameter as in required in sequential modular approach, you have to click on that. Now in mixture, if the moment you specify both the streams, the outlet is specified, but in splitter you have to specify that what you would like to do. So if you need any help, you click on this, you get all the help related to stream divider. And here it is a flow ratio. You can even give the molar flow rate. So 250 is the mole flow rate, right? You can even go with mass flow rate, or you can back calculate feed rate. So if you have given one of the outside units, like both the outside or the streams which are output, it calculates the one which is this. So say we go with flow ratio. So flow ratio is, this is stream number 4, this is stream number 5. So say 10% is going into stream 4. So I write this, and I write here, I press OK. Okay. So I think I just need to do this, press OK, and then select, run selected, it is done. So if I see this, this is 350, and 1% will go here. So if I again go to mole fractions, the mole fraction would be identical to the inlet. This will be 1. So 350, 1% of that is 35, and remaining goes to the other. So this is how you can use this. Mixture, we know, many times mixture comes as a mixture only in our flow sheet. But when to use this splitter? Splitter are generally being used when we try to simulate a recycle problem, where we have a purge. So if something is to be purged out, you have this. So this is called divider or stream splitter. There are various names given, but I think you now must be clear how to simulate basic unit operations like mixture and flow splitter in template. You can also do that standalone. I have first standalone I simulated mixture. In the same way, you give one feed stream and two product stream, and you can do that. I just wanted to show you how to connect two unit operations in one flow sheet. That's why I have eliminated the product from mixture and replaced that with this connector. So I think the idea must be clear to all of you. You can have a try at simulating various simple operations. Like compressor or expander, where you just need to drag and drop the units and provide the input and output depending upon what they need. So when you click on that, you get all the required things. Some of them I'll be able to show you in the upcoming videos. So keep learning. Thank you very much.